So I'm Ken Peary. I'm a principal with Walker Macy Landscape Architects and Planners. I am the project manager for this project, and I'm going to walk you through some of our thinking about how to better knit downtown Salem together with surrounding destinations and also to create a feeling of cohesiveness downtown. So in this board here, we have two maps. One map that describes where older sidewalk improvements have been made. And those we found are actually failing and they're harder to maintain. So we're going to look at ways to simplify the sidewalk and maybe reduce some of those conflicts. We're also looking at where there are existing trees downtown and where there might be opportunities to add trees in the future. Moving over to this board, you can see some of our initial recommendations and concepts. The first column talks about a pretty simple idea, which is just to fill in the gaps in terms of street trees downtown. So where you don't have trees planted in the long term, let's try to get a full canopy of street trees through downtown. We want to make sure that it's a diverse canopy because you don't want to plant the same species of tree everywhere because then you're susceptible to disease. We're also looking at ways to come up with a simpler, clearer sidewalk. And this is an idea where you create these zones, where there's a zone next to the parked cars where you have furnishings and trees, things like benches and bike racks and trash cans. And then you have a really clear zone for pedestrians to walk. And then finally, looking here, we noticed that there are inconsistent furnishings downtown. So we'd like to create a simple palette that feels like it's part of Salem, that takes design cues from the city. And then this is a rendering that sort of a watercolor that shows some of the benefits on a streetscape with more landscape, more seating areas, and a clear walking zone.
Hi, I'm Alyssa Pishka. I'm with Leland Consulting Group and part of the consulting team. So what we're talking about at this station today is about celebrating the landscape and brightening downtown through intentional lighting. So the first element is regarding the landscape. So currently, as we identified here, there's a lot of varied planting conditions. Unfortunately, a lot of the tree roots right now are pretty constricted. And then at the same time, there's different type of planting standards. So we're looking to provide more continuity in this, as well as how do we allow more opportunity for these trees to thrive within the area. The other element that's critical for a healthy downtown is adequate lighting. Provide safety and visual cues to anyone around the downtown of where should they be going. So this is a really good example right here of what it would look like with intentional design of the trees being lit up at night. It's obviously a corridor, keeps you walking and feeling safe along these areas at night. The other element with lighting comes into the light pole standards. So this is reflecting the historic light poles that are there right now in more of the southern portion of downtown.
My name is Morgan Maioli. I'm an urban designer with Walker Macy, and we are looking at wayfinding and art in the streetscape at this station. We heard from the public a lot about the need to create continuity and interest on their streetscapes, and when we looked at some of the connections, for example, the connection between the Capitol and the rest of downtown, we heard a lot of people say that they don't walk those two blocks between the Capitol and downtown because it's not interesting, it's kind of intimidating, there's not a lot of life, and it seems like the streetscape continuity breaks down. So we want to look at wayfinding in the streetscape, and the streetscape can offer wayfinding just in the way it's designed. It doesn't always have to be a sign, but it can be a tree canopy that doesn't break, or a continuous sidewalk zone, or a color that continues that lets you know there's something further on. Keep walking, like the activity continues. We looked at some specific areas. This is one example. The crossing to Riverfront Park is another big one. We want to make that more comfortable and brighter and engaging. And so we started with the existing crossing today and then looked at some ideas to make that more inviting. We can start to employ things like brighter colors that activate that pedestrian entry and say, this is a place for people, this is fun, you're welcome here. We can look at improving the crossing that's very worn now to signal pedestrian priority. More lush plantings and trees can make a street wall and make the street feel less wide. They can make it feel like a shorter walk, like more pedestrian scale. So at this point in our streetscape project, we want to think about how we integrate art in the streetscape. And it can be used as wayfinding as well. We just grab some examples to show the public to gauge their interest in this. But if you use vertical art pieces, maybe they light up at night, that can signal that something continues down ahead. And then we looked at some more interesting ways to integrate history into the streetscape. It doesn't have to be just a sign. It could be something in the pavement.
My name is Soumya Kinney. I'm an urban designer at Walker Macy Landscape Architects and Urban Planners. One of our four major recommendations for the downtown streetscape is to establish and support social spaces. Something that we heard from a lot of people that we've talked to over the last couple of months, I guess a lot of folks that we've talked to over the last couple of months, is that downtown is a place you go to hang out together, go to Saturday brunch together, spend time together and socialize. So we want the sidewalk spaces to really be able to support that. Part of that is about clarifying where outdoor dining can happen, where and how furniture should be designed that's public street furniture. Part of that is also improving alley entrances, because we've heard that alleys are a place that people gather and socialize. Some of the actions that can be taken to improve social spaces in downtown sidewalks. Obviously improving the alley entrances in terms of safety, walkability, adding pockets of landscape and seating space wherever there's underutilized space, the opportunity to add trees where appropriate. When we think about designing seating on a sidewalk, we want to organize it so that it encourages social interaction, not just a bench plopped down on a sidewalk, but maybe it's like a series of chairs that face each other.